sida envoygii weynaa ee qaabilsanaa Soomaaliya Somaliland ee ka socday Norway hore weyba 2007 baa ugu dambeysay envoyga yaana waxaanu ka wada hadlaynaa sidii dowladda Norway oo dowlad weyn aan cilaaqaad wanaagsan leenahay sidaan cilaaqaadkayga horumarka uga wada hadli lahayn si aan u kobcin lahayn si aan u wada shaqayn lahayn Norway waxay khibrad xoog leh u leedahay arrimaha shidaalka arrimaha natural resources-ka sida waxay nooga tari lahayd inaguna dhisi lahayd capacity iyo aqoon ama ha noqoto kalluun ama horumar kale ha noqoto marka waxaan isugu nimid inaan ka wada hadalo sida ay ulsoo wax uga qaban lahaayeen arrimaha naga dhexeeya ninkii Muqdisho ee ka mid ahaa wadahadalladu ee hore ugu socon lahaayeen arrimaha iyo arrimo badan oo nabadda iyo regionka waxaan ka qaban xagga qurxabadeedka oo aad iyo aad ay u tixgeliyaan inaanu shaqo fiican ka qabanno hadeennahay Soomaaliland iyo xagga argagixisada oonu shaqo wanaagsan ka qabannay ayay aad ugu tahniyadeeyeen waxaanu doonaa inaan cilaaqaad buuxda oo dan la yeelano dowladda Norway waa dowlad aad iyo aad khibrad u leh xagga wadahadallada xagga shidaalka xagga maxdanta oo khibrad caalami ah oo noqoto badanaa fardoon oo badan oo ku qabsay marka waxay doonayaan wax nala qabtaan inaan la shaqeyno inaan soo dhaweynaan doonaa aad iyo aad baan mar labaad ugu mahadnaqaynaa envoyga iyo waftigiisa noogu yimid halkan waanu mahadsan yahay let me say also a few words in English let me take this opportunity first to welcome the envoy to Somaliland the envoy of Norway is visiting here to meet the president and the government of Somaliland and the purpose of this visit was mainly to establish a better working relationship and to strengthen our cooperation Norway is a friendly nation is a nation which is very neutral when it comes to the world they have a lot of experience when it comes to issues related to the dialogue Norway has a lot of experience and capacity when it comes to natural resources, oil management, and we have requested the envoy and his team to support Somaliland establish better working relationships with Mogadishu. We have asked also the envoy to help Somaliland to have the capacity when it comes to resource management, natural resource management, the oil, because they have that experience. And we want to work with the government of Norway when it comes to issues of development. We have requested that they should provide some development assistance to us. And we would like to welcome them again to Somaliland. And we would like to be working with the envoy in the future. He happened to be a friend of mine from Jerusalem. Welcome once again. And thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I have to be careful with what I am saying because we have a lot of Somalilanders in Norway. And as you know, news are traveling very fast, so probably I will be asked difficult questions when I come back to Oslo. This aside, we came here to start discussion with the government here in Hargeisa. And our motivation is very simple. We would like to see how we can assist Somaliland Somalia becoming a stable and prosperous part of the African Horn. Today, whole of Somalia is a very poor country. But you are sitting on a lot of resources all over the country and in the sea, and you have fish and you have so many opportunities. And for the future generation, if you don't find a political formula to sort out all these issues, you will also be poor in the future. These are serious issues, and we would like to see how best we can assist you in improving the dialogue, technically. And the starting point for me as an envoy from the Norwegian government is that, seen from Norway, there is only one Somalia. There is only one Somalia for Norway. But what will be in the future depends on you. So we have to have a quite pragmatic approach to these issues, and a very practical, and at the same time, principled and political. And we are seeking a formula where we can have a role to play eventually, where we assist you in both developing political stability, improving dialogue, and at the same time assisting in capacity building and